Hey guys, what's up? This is ScherBR. Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is about romancing SaGa universe, and we'll be talking about Rouge seeking his other half. This is the name of the style of this Rouge. It's an SS style, and you can actually farm for him. You can't summon for him by normal ways, only by using spiral corridor tickets. On the platinum summon, he's still not available, and he's very important to clear some content because of incredible choice of spells that can be used in your favor. But in order to talk about Rouge, we need to talk about how can you farm for him. It's actually very easy to start farming for him, but to get him to actually drop, it's not. He is available on this stage called the Summit Gate on 1.2.12 on the story mode. Very easy to get to this point. I think you can get here in less than an hour depending on how you play the game. You will be facing the second boss on the Blue Dragon. When you start this, you may need to play on manual, but then just use some expedition tickets if you are having trouble and farm this on auto so it can make it a little easier for you. But the other thing is that it's very hard to get this character to drop because the chances are 0.7%. Not even 1% chances, guys. And I must assure you, he is very worth the trouble. Even if you play this for one day, maybe sometimes you'll be playing this for 2 days straight. I don't know. I know it can be hard. Maybe you won't have the patience to try to farm for him. Talking about the chances, it's 0.7, like I said. So that averages 150 runs to get him to drop. Some people will get it with 10 runs, some people will have to try for 400, I don't know. Sometimes RNG is not on your side and you don't have any other thing to do. You can just simply farm for your Rouge. And it's best to farm for him when you're starting the game because you get some energy loop, stamina loop, and you can just play it for a lot of time. You'll be getting more ranks, more staminas. It will get a loop, you won't need to wait. You can play for quite a lot of time, for even some hours, without having to worry about stamina. But if you are late on the game, you have to do this some runs when you have the time, using some stamina potions. But he's still very worth. So, besides just talking about this, I want to explain to you why he is just so strong. In order to talk about this, we'll be showing him in action. He's very known because he's one of the best characters that can inflict paralyze. He has a lot of good things going for him, so I'll be clicking here on style so we can check for him. Let me click here on Rouge. Rouge is just so nice. Let's talk about his three attacks. We have Rocking. It is an attack that can inflict stun. Stun is not like paralyze. Paralyze is something that gets inflicted for 4 turns, and stun only works for 1 turn, and only if the enemy is still didn't act. So you have to be faster than your enemy. We have Drain Energy that recovers HP when he attacks, and is a small effect, but it will heal for some good values, I think. It kinda helps out if you are using a healer. The healer will heal other character instead of Rouge, and this kinda makes up for a lot of savings. We also have Vermilion Sands. Vermilion Sands is an AoE attack that will hit all enemies. The power is not so high, it's on B power, and the cost is very high with 15 BP, and it's good to be used on waves of enemies. At least 3 enemies is when I recommend you guys using this, and also only when you can't use Paralyze. This guy will be using only one skill. But you see that these 3 skills are not about paralyzed, but he is the king of paralyzed. You have to learn it from the A style. You just have to search from here. We have A style Rouge. You have to summon for this Rouge. Fortunately, there's no way for you to get him besides summon. It may take some time for you to get, but maybe if you just got lucky, and we have a lot of free summons on this game, and you also don't need to worry about hates because A style has very high hates, but there's a lot of A styles, so this may take some time. But if you get Rouge A style, you can teach him any of these 3 skills. We have Shadow Chains. Shadow Chains is the overpower skill that we were talking about. Important to notice that we see here high chance. This is very important. It has a very, very high chance of being inflicted for 4 turns. So this means that you can paralyze, loop the enemy, getting it to paralyze it again. And it also costs only 3 BP. So you can use it every time without having to worry about your BP because you earn 3 new BPs every single turn. So he is the king of paralyze. But he also has another thing, as poisonous blow can be also useful. only when the enemy can be paralyzed, you can just switch out for Poisonous Blow. Okay, so, well, this guy seems very strong. Let's talk about how he is strong, his status as well. Let me see here, clicking on Rouge. We can see that he's CP and we can check some stuff. Let's just turn off both character and style. You can see that the character right now has the status. When we click on style, you see that he gets some good endurance, even through his mage. He also gets good aggy and good intelligence and good will. With a good endurance means that he is actually good to survive. It's even get better because of his passive abilities. Having a good aggy also means that you can use him on the back on some formations. Let's just close this and we'll check his ability. First one is Life Siphon. When he defeats a target, he will recover his HP, which is a matter of fact, it will be something like 30% of his HP. The second one, color is Conspicuous 2, has an endurance tilt stance with a magic effect. I think it's a very high chance it lasts for 4 turns. And in the hardy defense, number 4, we will reduce the incoming damage when he is on full HP with by a large effect. So it means that he will reduce by more values. Having stealth means that he won't be easily attacked. And having hardy defense means that when he is attacking, especially if it's an AoE attack that will hit him even if he is stealth, will reduce the incoming damage. Feeding a target and recovering HP is also very good because it means that you will have more space to heal other characters instead of Rouge. Not only that, but he has Drain Energy. Drain Energy will keep him with a good amount of HP. Sadly, it's 7 BP, but you can reduce this to 5. It will be a very good value. And even reduce your Shadow Chains to 2 BP, meaning that no matter what happens, you will always be able to use that. But 5 BP Drain Energy is also very good for sustain. Okay, so Rouge is very strong. You can see why he's strong. He's also belong to the Dark Element. We need to talk about this because you have to equip him with the correct equipment. Let's click here on Indeed Parties and you'll see what I'm using with my one. Right now in the game, you can only get this staff that carries the Dark Element. It can drop from the very hard mode. It can also drop from hard mode, but it's not so easy to get it. Dark Elemental Staff, it has a 26 weapon power when evolved and maxed, and 26 special power coming from Dark Element. So this increases his Dark Elemental damage. This is his best in slot weapon. The other equipment, I don't think it's so important to say. I don't even have Heresy yet. But I want to talk about his elemental resistance as well. Rouge has a very good elemental resistance. And also, let's see here, he is very, very strong against blunt damage. 70.9 on this point with my equipment and resistance against blunt damage. I think this is perfect. He can survive a lot of content that inflicts blunt damage as well. He's only very weak to Pierce, and then when you have Pierce, you will have some trouble to keep him alive. Okay, so you see, this is the best weapon. And then now that we talked about a lot of stuff, we want to see this guy in action. Because Rouge is also available on the Spiral Corridor Ticket Summon, we can watch him work by going here. You just have to click on Summon Details, and then you have to click on Styles. When you click on Styles, you can check the characters that are featured on this banner. And then we have Rouge here. You can click on Trial. And by clicking on Trial, you will see enemies, and you can use some of these attacks. I forgot to say something about Vermilion Sands. It has chance to inflict darkness on targets. So when an enemy has a darkness effect upon them, they will have less chances to hit you with their attacks. So, well, let's just start with the first one, Rocking. It's very interesting because it seems like a body move, but it's actually considered a spell. And the Drain Energy is has a very cool effect. It's just drain damage, very nice. And Vermilion Sands is just an AoE attack. Very beautiful, but the cost is very high. You have to reduce the BP cost of Vermilion Sands if you want to use this more often. So now let's just use him in actual combat, because I've been using him since I got him, even before I got the A style, and I was very, very happy with my Rouge. We can do this by choosing one stage here. I think the best one is this, the stage that I farm for Terry. Simply because not only by farming for Terror, this stage is very easy to clear as well. So now let's start this battle, then I'll show you my current squad. also using Sofia, Katarina, and also Albert and Nectar. Okay, this is my squad. I use Rouge on the back of my squad. You see, he's just using drain energy. Shouldn't have you that use it on the start. But let's just get to the last stage so we can watch his paralyze. The paralyze loop is the most important thing about him. You can also see that his normal attack increases his intelligence. This is something that happens with staff users. That's nice, because if you are stacking up some DP on the start of the wave, it means that you do even more damage when you use your mag. Okay, now we just have to choose the current spell, Shadow Chains, learn it from the EA style, and then let's just attack normally with the other ones. I like to use Rouge on this for me. You see, the enemy was weak to dark and also paralyzed it, so he will be paralyzed for 4 turns. Having a high Aggy with your Rouge will also help out by making the enemy paralyzed before he even moves. This is why this is so important. And can even be inflicted in some bosses. Guys, just farm Rouge. Even if it takes you 1 day, even if it takes you 2 days, you are also farming for status. Just bring the characters that are still underleveled. In this game, you probably want to level up as many characters as you want. Do not need to max them out, but level up a little, because you can get some masteries and other stuff. It will really help you out within time. So I think this is it, guys. You just watched Rouge. Rouge is a very strong character. I really recommend you guys on investing on him. So this is it. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe if you still haven't, and we see each other on the next one. Bye.